This week, we're thinking about Jesus as King. Let's pray. Father, we give you thanks that your Son Jesus is the King of Kings and our Saviour, that you so loved the world that you gave him to us, and through him we are set free from sin and fear. Help us to keep Jesus as the King of our hearts, and give us the ability, the courage, and the will to do what Jesus taught us, to love you, God, love our neighbour, and to do for others what we'd have them do for us. We pray for those in our town, in our country, and in the world, wherever they are, who are in need of you. Cast out darkness in people's hearts and replace it with your light. Be with us this coming week and help us to remember that Christ the King is also our brother, and help us go through this week with that in mind. In Jesus' name, Amen. For hundreds of years, God promised the birth of a Saviour. After Adam and Eve's original sin in the Garden of Eden, we needed a route to be made right with God. We cannot be made right with God by ourselves. No amount of goodness can do it. Only a Saviour can. The prophet Jeremiah said this Saviour would be a descendant of King David, and that he would reign as king. So for all those years, God's people watched, waited, and hoped for their Saviour or Messiah King to arrive. Prophets told how and where the Saviour would be born, and when Jesus was born in Bethlehem, he fulfilled the words the prophets had spoken. When we think of a king, we think of someone who is very privileged, who has a lot of power, wealth, and who perhaps lives in a palace or castle. Jesus, of course, was not born into any type of splendour on earth. His birthplace was a stable. Some of you will remember the births of the newest children in our royal family. When our future king, Prince George, was born, the world's media had gathered outside the London hospital awaiting news of the new royal baby. The whole world knew about Prince George very soon after his arrival. Jesus arrived fairly silently, apart from a group of shepherds being told about it by a host of angels, and some wise men from the east setting out on a journey after recognising a sign in the heavens which signalled the birth of the Messiah. Nobody else knew exactly who had been born in the stable that night. Jesus denied the idea that he was a king on earth, and showed this in one of the many humble things he did when he washed the feet of the disciples at the Last Supper. Later that same night, when the Roman governor, Pontius Pilate, asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not of this world." Jesus is a king, but not a worldly one, and was not what the Jewish people expected. They hoped for a conquering king to overthrow the Romans. Definitely not a king who died for people's sins on a cross. It was the expectation of a great king that caused the wise men to look for the baby Jesus in Jerusalem at Herod's palace, and caused King Herod to imagine Jesus to be a rival to himself. Jesus did not fit any of the images others had of the Messiah King. Jesus was a servant king, a suffering king, a sacrificed king. He was misunderstood. This type of king did not make sense to them, and therefore he was not accepted by most of his people. Jesus came and turned things upside down. He took the weight of the laws of men away. The Jewish people had, and still have, 613 laws. Jesus' message was that even if they followed every single one of those laws, if they weren't kind to each other or didn't treat people in a nice way, the laws were useless. Part of Jesus' message was that instead of toiling to obey all of those laws, they could be summed up in the one royal law, referred to in James, chapter 2, verse 8. To love God with all your heart and to love your neighbour as yourself. Every other one of the commandments is kept if you keep this law. Jesus said he'd take the weight from us, and he did. He took the weight of the law, and on the cross he took the weight of our sin. Our way back to God is by trusting Jesus. We can come just as we are and accept the gift of the work he's done for us. We can't ever be good enough or keep even the royal law perfectly, but God understands that. We need to try to be the best people we can be, but when we fail, we can come to Jesus and know that we're forgiven. When Jesus is King in our hearts, we're given the strength to do our best, but Jesus' work on the cross is what lifts the heaviness of sin from us and brings us back to God. As humans, it's impossible for us to be perfect, but Jesus came to be perfect for us. So God can now cancel out what we do wrong. If we just say sorry and mean it, Jesus' punishment on the cross was what humans deserved, and we now don't face it, because he took it for us. Jesus, the servant king, can bring us back to being perfect for God. That is what he meant when he said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me," in John 14, verse 6.
the splendor of a king, clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great.
Aim for the week. Let's try to place Jesus as King in our hearts this week. Whilst many things in the world try to get our attention, let's remember who to focus our hearts and minds on.